Welcome back to my corner of the internet. Okay, so tonight I'm reacting to Megan Fox being mistreated by interviewers for 9 minutes. Damn, some of these interviewers, man, I cannot. like for real. If I ever got famous, I don't think I could do these kind of interviews because I cuss too much. Plain and fucking simple. I cuss too much. So much bleeping out. That is, they can catch the loops in time. Okay, I'm just gonna shut up and just get on with it. Okay, without further ado, I'm about to get into this reaction. For some reason, I cannot get Payday out of my head. It's a good song, though. Alright, where's the point? It's recording. Good intro, though.
Genuine psychological breakdown, probably, where I wanted just nothing to do. I didn't want to be seen. I didn't want to have to take a photo. I didn't want to have to do a magazine. I didn't want to have to walk a carpet. I mean, it would be like, I'm Megan and I'm agoraphobic and you should never have cast me on the show.
Wait, what? What's that done like this? I'm gonna try and read aloud because I'm literally just gonna butcher what's written.
French balayage, my L'Oréal professionnel Paris. Natural looking, whatever your balayage desire.
I'm not gonna lie, I poured a double shot in this one. Maybe triple.
The funniest people, just naturally. It's hard to make friends.
Yeah, I mean, someone who died because, you know, diabetes is really chronic there. But, I mean, like, there's three or four that I kept in contact with, and they're really good people. You know? Because fat people aren't bad people. And that's one of the main things they teach you there.
The thing with Megan, I would notice after I had that interaction with her. I've known her a little bit because I know her husband really well. And then I noticed that every time
we would be shooting,
she'd be reading a book of substance. Like, that's what she does when she's not on set. So I was like, all right. Meanwhile, what do you...
a comfortable, fun thing. But I know that experience was not that way with my crew. I loved my crew, and I had two great experiences making the Transformer movies. And it was an anonymous letter. It could be anyone. It could be somebody that works at Cracker Barrel in Florida. Like, who knows who it is? But it's not true. My crew knows it's not true. And my producers know it's not true. And, you know, it's unfortunate that it would change public opinion. That, of course, hurts my feelings. I don't ever want people to think I'm difficult to work with or that I'm a bitch, because I try to go out of my way to make people feel comfortable. I've worked with people who have been difficult but have been male, and there's never a...
Mm-hmm.
just turned 15 and I was an extra in Bad Boys 2.
Really?
And yeah, they were shooting this club scene and they brought me in and I was wearing a Stars and Stripes bikini and a red cowboy hat and like 6-inch heels. And he approved it and they said, you know, Michael, she's 15, so you can't sit her at the bar and she can't have a drink in her hand. So his solution to that problem was to then have me dancing underneath a waterfall getting soaking wet. And that's
perfectly wholesome.
That probably makes it worse.
That's sort of a microcosm of how Bay's mind works.
That just makes it worse.
Well, that's really a microcosm of how all our minds work, but some of us have the decency to repress those thoughts and pretend that they don't exist.
Right.
Did he, there were...
I was an extra in Bad Boys 2.
Okay.
Which is also a Michael Bay film. And I was just sort of in the background. I was 15 at the time, so I was underage, but I was in a Stars and Stripes bikini and a red cowboy hat dancing under a waterfall. That was my first job.
Why are you clapping for that?
And you see, I knew this. We got the film. We went...
She has to do it better.
It's one of these fast cut movies, so we went frame by frame. So you're gonna see this. You're gonna see your acting debut right now for the very first time.
Do you numb yourself to? I don't know if there's ever. I don't know if there's a man alive who's not in love with you in some way.
You're so silly.
You know what I'm? Am I really?
You're a silly man.
No, I'm not silly at all.
You're a silly man in a checkered shirt.
I am not.
Don't say that.
What is your, before we go, what is your life like? Do you have a handle on your life right now?
Oh, sure.
What kind of questions are these?
What do you mean?
You have to go into every situation when you have a conversation with a man you've never met that is going to end at some point with him flirting with you.
No, absolutely not. Johnny's never flirted with me once.
He's been flirting the whole time we've been sitting
here.
Oh,
is that what flirting is?
See, now I think you're flirting with me. I'm kidding. Totally kidding.
Really?
In the first Transformers, you were just like a toy, the girl or the boy, you know, something
sure.
like this.
Okay.
And this one, you are just... Michael Bay makes you an icon.
Okay.
Are you aware?
I'm not aware.
No, come on.
Are you silly?
I thought of a sex icon, the shot on the motto.
Don't say that. Rise, please, me.
The motorcycle.
Who can't bend over a motorcycle? What did I do? If you ask
anybody
so
else,
they one-handed push-ups.
Please interview.
I just bent over a motorcycle. Yay!
Really, it's not really about what you did, but what he did.
He did.
Was that water in there, Megan? I wouldn't blame you if it wasn't. So don't see if I was a chick and they asked me a question like this, I wouldn't just be drinking from a wine glass. I'd be having fucking shots back to back. I mean, if you're gonna ask these questions that I'm comfortable with, I might as well just get drunk just to not remember them. But
yeah,
sure,
this
is something that alcohol can never block out.
Thank God for Michael Bay. If I could have Michael Bay with me every
just
moment
saying.
Of every day, I would, believe me.
Mm-hmm. Really?
No.
What are you going to do next? Because you are a sex icon. Don't
you
mind.
Are so crazy. Go ahead.
No, really. But look at the cover.
Look at it.
Yeah. I look at it. And really, what are you gonna do?
You mean like how will I top myself? Is this what you're asking,
no.
Or just literally what am I doing next?
God.
Did you blame Transformers 2 to make Woody Allen's movie, for example? If you know what I mean.
You know, I don't think Woody Allen watches Transformers to scout for new talent for his films. I don't think that happens. I made Transformers 2 because I owed Michael Bay whatever he wants, because he gave me a career. And I love Shy, and I love my crew, and I will come back for them whenever they need me. I feel blessed to think that they need me. It's crazy, if they do.
She strikes me as a very loyal type.
You know,
I like that.
Step from playing in a movie like this and
mm-hmm.
becoming a proper actress.
Right.
Do you agree?
Yeah, I do agree.
And
sure.
You want to become a proper actress and
what's my plan for becoming a real actress?
I think you are a real actress in this one.
Oh, you are so silly. I've never seen Kate Winslet bend over a motorcycle.
One last thing.
What is it?
Please, can you give me a kiss?
On the
what
mouth?
The fuck?
To go over to my boyfriend's house, his sister usually cooks.
Okay, now it's done. It's done. What can I say? This is what I call unprofessionalism. Oh my god. I drink water, strong enough to deal with this. Okay. Well, what can I say? Megan deserved better. Than these questions, right? That's all I have to say. But I'm definitely gonna react to more, I think. If anyone's got a recommendation, keep them coming. Keep them coming. Okay, so that's it for this video. Like, subscribe if you want. I post if whenever I feel like it, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!